since we are understanding some basic curves, so that we are able to solve our equations and inequalities. Why we are doing it? So that we will be able to solve our equations and inequalities smartly. So mostly if you see class 11th people, they, when they start this inequality chapter, they start doing algebraically. But the idea is not algebraically, the idea should be graphically. That is why I am giving you a little flavor of basic graphs. Okay. Now tell me, you must have heard of this function. Exponential. इन्हें पता नहीं है कि रिकॉर्ड होता है तो दे कैन हैव बिकॉज वी हैव अ वेरी शॉर्ट स्पैन आई कैन नॉट कैन डी राइट टू हर दैट वी डोंट हैव मच टाइम बिकॉज इफ यू स्टार्ट एक्सप्लेनिंग मतलब जस्ट आस्क हर टू लॉग इन टू द चैनल एंड कैन गो थ्रू इट Have you heard of this word, exponent? Exponent पढ़ा है ना? और exponential function क्या हुआ? Simple, y is equal to a to the power x. Y is equal to. Now my question is, what a can be? A can be any number. Or can a be a negative number? Let's say if I have to find y is equal to minus 4. To the power x. If I put half, will I be able to get real value? So there will be infinite points जहाँ पे ये function defined ही नहीं होगा, है ना? There will be infinite points जहाँ पे ये function, क्योंकि between two points you have infinite points, between two numbers you have infinite numbers, और वो infinite numbers है बहुत सारे infinite values पे ये defined ही नहीं होगा, तो तुम कभी graph draw कर पाओगी? Will you be able to call it a function? So it won't be called a exponential function. So, सबसे पहले तुम्हें पता चला कि a needs to be positive. अच्छा zero रख सकती हो क्या? Y is equal to zero to the power x. Negative values के लिए defined होगा क्या? Zero to the power minus one, can you define it? अरे बेटा साहब ने कहा है ना कि zero नहीं रखना है नीचे, हाँ? तो zero to the power x के लिए defined है? नहीं है. So again, we won't call it a exponential function. Now if you say y is equal to 1 to the power x, ये function क्या होगा? ये हर values के लिए 1 होगा, straight function. So it's not basically exponential function, it's a constant function. So a की values क्या क्या हो सकती है? A two cases हो गए. यही दो केस हो सकता है, right? Either a is lying between 0 to 1 or greater than 1. So basically two cases. So dono cases mein kaisa graph hoga wo hum dekhenge. To pehle hum ye case dekhte hain. A greater than 1 ka case dekhte hain. Koi bhi number choose karo, kaun sa number pick kare? 2. 2 pick karte hain. To y is equal to 2 to the power x. Hum ye draw karenge. Theek hai? Jab isko draw karoge to kaise draw karoge dekho. ये तुम्हारा कार्टेशियन सिस्टम आ गया. x को जीरो डालो, क्या होगा? वन. यहां पे हुआ कहीं जीरो कॉमा वन. वन डालो, वन कॉमा टू, टू कॉमा फोर, थ्री कॉमा एट. सो इट्स बेसिकली राइजिंग, इंक्रीजिंग, स्टीपनेस की तरह, है ना? सो आई कैन इजली प्रेडिक्ट दैट इट वुड बी समथिंग लाइक दिस, राइट? इंक्रीज करता जाएगा जैसे जैसे तुम एक्स की वैल्यू बढ़ाते जाओगे, है ना? इट विल बी राइजिंग दिस वे. नाउ पुट माइनस वन हियर, वन बाई टू, माइनस टू वन बाई फोर, माइनस थ्री वन बाई एट, माइनस फोर वन बाई सिक्सटीन, माइनस हंड्रेड वन अपॉन टू टू द पावर हंड्रेड, माइनस करोड़ वन अपॉन टू टू द पावर करोड़. मतलब क्या हो रहा है? जीरो नहीं हो रहा है लेकिन बहुत ही जीरो के पास जा रहा है, लेकिन जीरो कभी नहीं हो रहा है. देखो हाफ, वन बाई फोर, वन बाई एट, मतलब हमेशा हाफ 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 होता जा रहा है, लेकिन इस लाइन को नहीं क्रॉस कर रहा, इस लाइन को टच भी नहीं कर रहा. अपीयर करेगा कि कहीं पे करेगा लेकिन हर बार बच जा रहा है टच करने से. ऐसा कुछ होगा? So this is the graph of y is equal to 2 to the power x. Understood or not understood?
Understood.
Hai na? ठीक है. Now tell me, मुझे y is equal to 3 to the power x बनाना है. तो क्या होगा? X to the power 0 पे क्या होगा? तो यहाँ पे तो पक्का होगा. लेकिन हर वैल्यू पे अब बढ़ेगा, तो स्टीपर होगा. और यहाँ पे शैलोअर होगा, है ना? लेकिन फिर भी वो कभी 0 को टच नहीं करेगा. अंडरस्टूड? तो आपको बेसिक आइडिया पता चल गया. 2 से 3, 3 से 4 और स्टीपर और शैलोअर, और स्टीपर और शैलोअर, और स्टीपर और शैलोअर, जैसे जैसे आप a की वैल्यू बढ़ा रहे हो. तो बेसिक आइडिया इज, व्हेन यू ड्रॉ y इज इक्वल टू a टू द पावर x, व्हेन a इज ग्रेटर देन 1, द ग्राफ विल अपीयर लाइक दिस. दिस इज 0, 1. ओके, नाउ If you observe intuitively, what you can say? आप left से right x axis पे move करते हो, तो आप क्या करते हो? X increase करता है ना? जब आप left से right जाते हो तो? और y down से bottom से top जाते हो तो increase करता है. तो आप देखो, जैसे आप left से right की तरफ travel कर रहे हो, आपका curve ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है. So as the values of x increases, the value of y increases. When this happens, we call it increasing function. We call it
increasing function.
Increasing. As the value of x increases, the value of y also increases. इसे हम कहते हैं strictly increasing. Strictly. देखो, there is a difference between increasing function and strictly increasing function. What is the difference? That increasing function means equal भी हो सकता है. जैसे मतलब घटना नहीं चाहिए. और स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग दैट इट विल ऑलवेज इंक्रीज, जैसे जैसे तुम बढ़ोगे बढ़ता ही जाएगा, इक्वल भी नहीं होगा. अंडरस्टूड? सो स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग फंक्शन का मतलब क्या हुआ? एज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इंक्रीजेज, वैल्यू ऑफ वाई इंक्रीजेज. एज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इंक्रीजेज, वैल्यू ऑफ वाई डिक्रीजेज. स्ट्रिक्टली डिक्रीजिंग फंक्शन. तो एक्स हमेशा इंक्रीज कर रहा है, x क्योंकि इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल है. x को जब आप इंक्रीज कर रहे हो तो y के साथ क्या हो रहा है उसको देखते हुए आप नाम रख रहे हो. ये मत कहना कि x इंक्रीज कर रहा है तो सर ये भी इंक्रीजिंग है. x को तो आप इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल है, वही तो आपका इनपुट है, उसको आप देख रहे हो, वो उसको आप हमेशा इंक्रीज करोगे. अगर वो इंक्रीज हो रहा है तो आपका ग्राफ y अगर ऊपर जा रहा है तो इसका मतलब स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग, और y अगर डिप डाउन कर रहा है तो स्ट्रिक्टली डिक्रीजिंग. ठीक है, तो ये आप इस पे ऑब्जर्व कर रहे हो. तो आप इसको देख रहे हो कि इट इज टेकिंग ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स, दिस ग्राफ इज टेकिंग ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स. तो एक वर्ड होता है डोमेन ऑफ अ फंक्शन, इसका नाम सुना है? क्या हो इसका डेफिनेशन होता है? ऑल द पॉसिबल वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स फॉर विच द फंक्शन इज वेल डिफाइंड. द फंक्शन इज वेल, तो आपको यह पता चल गया कि y इज इक्वल टू 8 टू द पावर x में इट इज टेकिंग ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ x. It is taking all the values of x. So what will be the domain? X is the element of? इसका मतलब समझ में आता है ना? X belongs to real values. Okay. या इसको आप ऐसे भी लिखते हो. Minus infinity से plus infinity. Right? अच्छा, आप लोगों को इस brackets का मतलब समझ में आता है? ये सारे पांचों को जानते हो? गुड. लास्ट स्पेसिफिक पॉइंट्स, स्पेसिफिक. जैसे इफ आई से 3, 4, ओनली 3, ओनली 4. दिस वन 3 टू 4, ऑल द वैल्यूज 3 टू 4 इंक्लूडिंग 3 एंड 4. ऑल द वैल्यूज 3, 4 इंक्लूडिंग 3, नॉट 4. नॉट इंक्लूडिंग 3 बट इंक्लूडिंग 4 एंड ऑल द वैल्यूज. ऑल द वैल्यूज बिटवीन 3 एंड 4 बट नॉट इंक्लूडिंग द एक्सट्रीम वंस. ओके, सो यू नो द डोमेन ऑफ दिस फंक्शन. What is the range of a function? The set of values of y. The set of values of
y.
अब बताइए क्या कहते हैं, क्या क्या है इसकी values of y? क्या ये negative हो रहा है कभी? कभी ये zero हो रहा है क्या? लेकिन zero से छोटा, जरा सा भी बड़ा हो रहा है? हाँ. It is taking all the values above zero.
The
हाँ यस सो रेंज इज गोइंग टू बी 0 टू इन्फिनिटी. इन्फिनिटी इज ऑलवेज केप्ट इन ओपन ब्रैकेट. वाई? बिकॉज इन्फिनिटी इज नॉट अ नंबर. अंडरस्टूड? क्लियर और नॉट क्लियर? यहां तक कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है? तो आपने, आपको कोई भी बोलेगा वाई इज इक्वल टू ई टू द पावर एक्स का ग्राफ ड्रॉ करने को, और ए अगर 1 से बड़ा है तो आप तुरंत ड्रॉ कर दोगे, और वो स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग है. स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग का मतलब क्या हुआ? ठीक है, इक्वेशन, इन इक्वेशन वाइज उसका मतलब क्या हुआ? If I say 3 to the power 50 and 3 to the power 60, which is greater? Q? Kyunki y is equal to 3 to the power x is a strictly increasing function. To agar x 50 se 60 badhega, to y bhi badhega. Understood? Inequality mein bahut important hai strictly increasing or strictly decreasing a concept. Clear or not clear? Pakka? So you know how to draw y is equal to a to the power x when a is greater than 1. Now let's try any number between 0 to 1. So if I say, just take last example, if I say 3 to the power alpha is greater than 3 to the power beta, to alpha or beta mein bada kaun hoga?
Alpha.
Why? Because y is equal to 3 to the power x is a strictly increasing function. Achha, iska kya hoga? Pi to the power alpha or pi to the power beta, if this is greater, which is alpha beta bada kaun hoga? Because pi is greater than 1, so it means it will be a increasing function. So 1 se jo bhi bada ho, base, aapko pata ho chal gaya ki wo increasing function hai. Now let's say you have to draw y is equal to half to the power x. Okay? So we'll start the same basic thing. X ko dalo 0, kya ho gaya? 1. X ko dalo 1, to kya ho jayega? 2 dalo to? 3 dalo to?
1/8.
Crore dalo to? 1/2 to the power crore. तो मतलब क्या हुआ? जीरो की तरफ बढ़े लेकिन जीरो नहीं बने. राइट? माइनस वन डालो, टू. माइनस टू डालो, माइनस थ्री डालो, माइनस फोर डालो, ठीक है. एज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इंक्रीजेज,
वैल्यू ऑफ वाई
डिक्रीजेज. As the value of x increases, value of y, which means
strictly decreasing function.
What is the domain? What is the range? It's taking all the values except 0 and negative. So don't write infinity to 0. Okay. When you say set, set means just a collection. आप कैसे, order is not important. ठीक है? Clear? समझ में आया? Okay. यहाँ पे strictly decreasing का interpret करो mathematically. If I say 0.7 to the power 812 and 0.7 to the power 810, which is greater? 810. क्यों? Because it is a decreasing function. As the value of x increases, the value of y
decreases.
So which will have a greater power? ठीक है? If I say root 3 by 2 to the power alpha is lesser than root 3 by 2 to the power beta. So which is greater, alpha or beta? अल्फा, अल्फा. समझ में आया? क्यों? क्योंकि ये डिक्रीजिंग फंक्शन है. तो आपने एक चीज क्या सीखी? कि अगर फंक्शन स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग होगा तो इनइक्वालिटी को चेंज करने में इनइक्वालिटी रिवर्स नहीं करेगा. व्हेन यू हैव टू ड्रॉप डाउन, यू हैव टू रिमूव द फंक्शन, द इनइक्वालिटी विल रिटेन अगर वो स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग है, और अगर स्ट्रिक्टली डिक्रीजिंग है तो इनइक्वालिटी विल रिवर्स. अंडरस्टूड? आपने दोनों एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन को सीख लिया, y इज इक्वल टू a टू द पावर x एंड y व्हेन a इज लाइंग बिटवीन 0 टू 1 एंड व्हेन a इज ग्रेटर देन 1. ओके, क्लियर? आप लोग उधर ना देखें, इधर देखें. ओनली इंग्लिश? आर वी टॉकिंग इन हिंदी? ओके, सो व्हेनेवर यू सी द फंक्शन इज स्ट्रिक्टली इंक्रीजिंग, व्हाट डू यू हैव टू सी? यू जस्ट हैव टू सी दैट when the function is strictly increasing, you just have to say that the inequality sign will retain. And if the inequality, if the function is strictly decreasing, the inequality will reverse. Good. अच्छा, इसका मतलब क्या होता है? What do you mean by log a b is equal to c? It means that by how much power you should raise a so that you get b, which means a to the power c should be equal to b. In the what is the relation between these two expression? They are actually the same. They are the same expression, right? So if I when you were in class 7th 8, I would have asked you 2 to the power 4, you would have said 16, right? If I would have asked you 7th square, you would have said 49. If I would have asked you 5 to the power x is equal to 1 by 25, you would have said minus 2. But you would have considered a difficult question than the other ones, but it could have been asked easily. If I was your mathematics teacher, I could have asked you and you won't have said that it's out of syllabus. Hai na? Simple, ki aapko what power you should give to 5 so that you get 1 by? But if I would have given you this, you would have shouted, screamed, so you didn't teach us log. But there is no difference between these two questions. Getting the idea? Same question, right? Yes. But you won't but you would have screamed there, you won't have screamed there, right? Understood or not understood the idea? So log is basically nothing but inverse of exponent. Square root is inverse of square. Cube root is inverse of cube. Kya ho raha tha when you were drawing cube root and cube? They were symmetrical about y is equal to x. Square root and square were symmetric about
y.
So what will happen to log x and y is equal to a to the power x? But y is equal to x. That is the idea of invertibility. So you can write it just with a star marks that inverse functions are symmetrical about y is equal to x line. So let's say I have to draw. So again, y is equal to log ax, I have to draw. It means a again has to be either between two cases, right? So I know this is y is equal to a to the power x. I know this is y is equal to x line. I know this is 0 comma 1, so what will be the mirror image? 1 comma 1. So this is 1. Understood or understood? Phir se batate hain. Ye to maine conceptually bata diya. let's say you have to draw y is equal to log 2x, right? X ko 0 dalo, dal sakte ho kya? 2 pe tum kitna power doge ki 0 aayega? 0 aayega hi nahi kabhi, hai na? Kyunki aapke exponent ka range kya tha? 0 se infinity, 0 kabhi nahi tha. Okay, now log 2 1, iska matlab kya hua? Log 2 1, what does it mean? It means how much power should I give 2 so that I get 1, so that is 0. So 0 comma 1, 1 comma 0, right? Log 2 2, log 2 4, log 2 8. So you see, your x is increasing in a larger fashion, your y is also increasing but in a slower fashion. So 1, 2, 3, aise hi bada hai na? See, it will be something like this. And this will be something, ab batao. Log 2 half, minus 1, 1 by 4, minus 2, 1 by 8, minus 3, 1 by 16, minus 4, right? Dip down, clear or not clear? Not clear. Where did you? From all the concepts, from exponents or from log?
Log.
Log. Okay. So you see y is equal to 8 to the power x and this y is equal to log 8x. You know that the invertible functions are symmetrical about y is equal to
x line.
X line. That is the idea. Okay, that is the idea. So I know how to, I know, acha, ek baat batao, if this is your y is equal to x line, if this is your y is equal to x line, this is y is equal to x line, right? Okay, this is let's say A comma B point. Okay, what will be the mirror image of this point? Nahi pata? Let's try. Let's draw a triangle. Ye triangle dekh rahe ho? It's a right angle triangle. What's the height? What's the base? Is triangle ka mirror image yahi hoga na? Ab dikh raha hai? हाँ, अब दिख रहा है? This is your base, this is your base, A, this is your height, this is your height. So what will be the abscissa? So what did you observe? That the abscissa becomes ordinate and the ordinate becomes
abscissa
when you reflect anything from y is equal to x line. That is why you have root x and y is equal to x square as a symmetrical thing. X cube and cube root x as symmetrical thing, log x and a to the power x as symmetrical thing. So, ek idea to aapko dikh gaya ki okay, this is the thing of exponential function, so I can draw the mirror image. Dekho, is line ka mirror image yehi hai na? Is line ka mirror image yehi hai na? Ye yahan approach kar raha to yahan approach kar raha hai na, dekho. Symmetrical to hai. Achha. Now think like a child. Y is equal to log 2x. ये आपका graph है. I'll draw the tables जो बचपन में करते थे. Table draw कर लो. ठीक है? इसमें x की value feed करो. 1 feed करो. Log 2 1 क्या होता है? ये x की value है. 0. 2 feed करो 1. 4 feed करो 2. 8 feed करो 3. Feed half.
-1 -2.
So you will get this thing. And hence I think everything is fine now, right? Okay. So what's the domain of this y is equal to log ax? Dekho, ye humne graph banaya hai log ax when a is greater than 1. When a is greater than 1. Is it an increasing function? Yes, it is increasing function. This was also increasing. This is also increasing. But thoda slow increase kar raha hai. But increase to kar raha hai. Koi aeroplane se ja raha hai, to koi train se ja raha hai, koi paidal chal raha hai, koi gaadi se chal raha hai. Lekin sab ghar pahunch rahe hai, right? Everyone is reaching their destination. Sab increase kar rahe hai. Okay, getting the idea? Now, if you see, what is the domain of this y is equal to log ax? Can x be negative? नहीं, हमारा graph तो totally right है, negative तो ले ही नहीं रहा है. Zero? No. So what is the domain? Yeah, you can write x greater than 0 or x is the element of 0 to infinity, right? That is your domain. Now let's talk about range. Can you see the range? It is dipping to minus infinity and it is going to plus infinity. So range is y is r or minus infinity say plus infinity, right? So got the idea? So I got it. So log concept again. Did we explain it again, na?
Yes, sir.
Which concept? I don't know. Once again, see, when you must understand what is the basic definition of log. When I say log base AB, it's simple. I'm asking you by what power should I give A so that I should get C, so that I should get B. That is nothing but an inverse of
exponent.
That is, jaise main aapko bolta tha, find me the x square root of 25. So you used to say 5. Otherwise, I would have said, find me where x is a positive number, x square is equal to 25, tell me what is x. Both are same question, right? Where one I am asking you to find the square root, where main aapse ulta puch raha hu, kisko square karke 25 aata. So they are inverse to each other. Similarly, log and exponents, they are inverse to each other. If I am traveling this way for exponent, I just need to travel this way for log. That is the idea. I am going from left to right, x to y for exponent, so I have to go from y to x for log, but we will be calling this as x and this as y for log function, right? So log is basically the inverse of
exponent.
The basic definition of log is by what power should you give that base so that you should get your this thing, the whatever log a b, right? So that is the idea, that is the basic definition. So we have already considered y is equal to a to the power x, both the cases, a when lying between 0 to 1 and when a is greater than 1. When a is greater than 1, we had drawn already the graph, that is y is equal to a to the power x. So we can say by logic which we have been observing that the inverse function, they are symmetric about y is equal to x line. So I can say that this will be the curve. But still, we thought like a kid also that let's say consider any number log 2x. So 2 is basically number greater than 1. So I just started asking myself what should be log 2 minus 5. So I thought ki 2 pe main kitna bhi power de do, minus 5 kabhi nahi aayega. So it can never get negative. So I just didn't go anywhere beyond y axis. Hai na? Y axis ke beyond main hi gaya left. So then I thought, what about 0? Again I asked myself ki by what power should I raise my 2 so that I get 0. There is no chance. So then I thought ki let's take better numbers. So 1. So 1, I know that 2 to the power 0 is 1. Then I thought 2 to the power 1 is 2. So I started taking 2, 4, 8. So I got 1, 2, 3. So I know that things will start increasing. And similarly, then I started taking fractions. Half, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16, and that gave me minus. And then I started plotting it, and then I got my answer, which resonated with the idea which we have already started. So that is the idea, right? When you hear the word log, stop getting afraid of it. That is the point where you do not able to solve, because you are afraid of this word log. Otherwise, log and exponent, they are the same story. Okay? Should we push further? So you know how to draw y is equal to log ax when a is greater than 1. So I hope now you can answer me. Log root 3 750, log root 3 800, which one will be greater? It's a strictly increasing function. So the, as the, this one, right? And if I say log root 3 alpha is greater than log root 3 beta, alpha is greater than beta because it's a strictly increasing function. Good. अच्छा उसमें मैंने बात नहीं की थी. अच्छा उसमें तो मैंने बात कर ली थी ना हाफ वाले पे. ओके गुड. Base depends. It's not that you have base is fixed, but for a particular function, base is fixed. You, the base can either be greater than 1 or base can be between 0 to 1. If for exponential case, if a is let's say 2, 3, 4, which is a fixed number, a is not variable, a is a fixed number, and it can be anything from 1 to infinity. So whatever it is, if it is from 1 to infinity, the graph would be this one, right? And if it is between 0 to 1, the graph would be this way, but a is a constant, don't forget that. Similarly, for log, if a is greater than 1, it can be anything, 700, 500, 800, anything greater than 1, root 3, root 5, anything. It needs to be this way, clear? The steepness will change, accordingly the values of a changes, but the basic shape remain same. Now, the last case, when log ax, when a is lying between 0 to 1.